إن الحمد لله نحمدك ربي ونستعينك ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك ونثني عليك الخير كله ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الملك الوهاب الغفور التواب الذي يقبل التوبة من عباده مهما عظمت الذنوب إذا تابوا إليه ويبدل سيئاتهم حسنات إذا أحسنوا العمل وأنابوا إليه لقوله سبحانه وتعالى إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما وإن تابوا إلي فأنا حبيبهم وإن لم يتوبوا فأنا طبيبهم ومن أتاني تائبا تلقيته من بعيد ومن أعرض عني ناديته من قريب أقول له يا عبدي يا عبدي أين تذهب ألك رب سواي ألك إله غيري وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه يا عباد الله وأشهد أن حبيبنا ونبينا وسيدنا وقائدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله قد أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين وقد شرح به الصدور وقد أنار به العقول وقد أخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور وهداهم على الصراط المستقيم اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على إمام المتقين وعلى إمام الخاشعين وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين أحبتي في الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى فاتقوه وأطيعوه وراقبوه ولا تعصوه All praises and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala To him belong all the praises and thanks. We praise him and we thank him and we seek his forgiveness and we ask him for his mercy. And none has the right to be worshipped except him, Allah. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and last messenger. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I advise myself and you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be feared. And to die as a true Muslim believers. As we discussed in the past, in the last Friday, about the importance of tawbah, the importance of repentance coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willing to forgive you no matter how much your sins, as long as you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawbah nasuha, sadiqa, a sincere repentance, coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today my subject is, there's a sin, a ma'siyah. We commit on a daily basis. And sometimes we don't recognize that we committed a ma'asiyah, this sin. It's caused by a lisan, by the tongue, the weakest muscle in your body. And this is the most dangerous part in your body. It can lead you to paradise, or it can lead you to hellfire. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ لَابُدْ أَنْ تَحْذَرْ هَذَا الثُّعْبَانِ أَتَدْرُونَ مَا الْغِيبَةِ أَتَدْرُونَ مَا الْغِيبَةِ يَا أَحِبَّتِي فِي اللَّهِ سأل هذا السؤال نبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أصحابه يوما فقال أتدرون ما الغيبة؟ فقالوا يا رسول الله إن الله ورسوله أعلم. قال إن الغيبة ذكرك أخاك بما يكره. فقام رجل وقال يا رسول الله وإن كان في أخي ما أقول. قال فإن قلت ما فيه فقد اغتبته، وإن لم تقل ما فيه فقد ظلمته أي بهته. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم asked his companions one day, do you know what الغيبة؟ Do you know what backbiting is? They said, Allah and His Messenger knows best. He said to mention your name of your brother in somewhere or some name he dislikes. A man stood up, he said, O Rasulullah, what if what I'm saying about my brother is true? He said, if it is true, فَقَدْ بَهَدْتَ أَيْ ظَلَمْتَ. And if it's true, also you commit backbiting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه فاتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon me and you al-nida'ul muhabbab ila al-qulub. Every time you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you in the Quran, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, pay attention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending a command on me and you, la yaghtab ba'dukum ba'da. Do not follow suspicions. Do not follow false tales. Do not spy on each other. And do not backbite each other. Who loves to eat from the flesh of his dead brother? Who likes to do that? فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ So you hate it. So hate backbiting. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ Then repent and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam صعد المنبر يوما واحمر وجهه وأعلى صوته فقال يا معشر الناس يا معشر الناس من آمن بلسانه ولم يصل الإيمان إلى قلبه لا تغتاب المسلمين لا تغتاب المسلمين ولا تقعوا في أعراضهم ولا تجسسوا عليهم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he said in his khutbah one day in a loud voice and his face became so red, said, oh people, oh you people, whomever believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his tongue, but his tongue did not reach his heart. This word he's saying did not reach his tongue. لا تغتاب المسلمين. Do not backbite the Muslims and do not spy on them. This is a command from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to follow. And Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كان في رحلة الإسراء والمعراج قد مر على أقوام لهم أظفار من نحاس يخمشون صدورهم ووجوههم فقال يا جبريل من هؤلاء يا جبريل من هؤلاء قال يا رسول الله هؤلاء الذين يغتابون المسلمين ويقعون في أعراضهم. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his journey in al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, he passed by a group of people. These people had fingernails made out of copper, scratching their faces and scratching their chests. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh Jibreel, who are these people? What type of these people are? What have they committed? They said, O Rasulullah, these type of people involved in backbiting. And they were spying on the Muslims. What are their punishment? What are their punishment? Their fingernails made out of copper, scratching their chests and scratching their faces. Imagine, that is the punishment of those who commit backbiting. Ma'az ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Faqala ya Rasulullah, tahhirni ya Rasulullah. Oh Rasulullah, purify me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking him, what have you done? Said, oh Rasulullah, I have committed a major sin. I committed zina. So purify me, O Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling him, اذهب وتب واستغفر الله سبحانه وتعالى. Go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to him. Make istighfar. Then this man come back again. قال تهرني يا رسول الله. See, when the believer, the true believer, when he commits a sin, he sees it like a mountain, ready to crush him. He cannot sleep with that sin one day. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned him and said, go back, repent, make istighfar. When a woman came to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, she said, Ya Abu Bakr, قد زنيت وقد قتلت فهل لي من توبة. This woman came to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. She said, oh Abu Bakr, I committed zina and I became pregnant and I killed my child and I am repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هل لي من توبة. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, he became angry with her. And then she left him. She's angry also. Till in the morning, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, oh Rasulullah, a woman came to me last night and she had committed these two major sins. I couldn't know what to reply to her. He said, oh Abu Bakr, why didn't you recite to her قول الله سبحانه وتعالى والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون. Oh Abu Bakr, didn't you remind her of these beautiful verses? For those the one who do not associate other God besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not kill an innocent soul, and do not commit zina, if they repented, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive their sins. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. Abu Bakr, why don't you recite to her these beautiful ayat? Tell her to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and renew your iman, your faith with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in the oneness of Allah and do good, righteous, good deeds. Surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. But Ma'az ibn Malik, he said, oh Rasulullah, I cannot wait any longer. Tahhirni ya Rasulullah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking his companions, أَهَلْ بِهِ جُنُونَ, something wrong with his mind. قَالُوا لَا يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his companions, أَهَلْ شَرِبَ خَمْرًا, is he intoxicated? Then a man came and smelled him, he said, لَا يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked choice, to stone him to death. Two men said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at this man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concealed his sins. قَدْ سَثَرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Nobody knew about this sin. But he couldn't hold himself. حَتَّى رُجِمَ رَجْمِ الْكَلْبِ, till he was stoned like a dog. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say anything to them till they passed by jifat himar, azzakum Allah, till they passed by a dead animal. And he said, Aina fulan wa fulan, where is so and so? Those who one who spoke earlier about the brother, where are they at? Qala ha nahnu ya Rasulullah. Qala nzila fa'kula min hadhihi al-jifa. قالوا رحم الله لك يا رسول الله غفر الله لك ومن يأكل من هذا. Rasulullah sallam told them to come down and eat from this dead animal. They said, oh Rasulullah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. And who will eat from this dead animal? They said, what you said earlier about your brother, worse than eating this dead animal. Ma'az ibn Malik, now he's swimming in the rivers of paradise. Allah accepted his tawbah. وَمَنْ تَابَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا. And the one who truly repent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his repentance. This is the true repentance, coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aisha radiyallahu anha, she telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ilayka bi Safiya, watch out for Safiya. The other wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya'ni inaha kasira, she just short. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became angry. Said, oh Aisha, you're saying so much words. Innaha kalima, qad qulti kalima, لو مزجت بماء البحر لمزجت, أي غيرت لونه غيرت رائحته. Oh Aisha, you said a word. If this word, you would put it in a river, a sea, this word will change its smell and will change its taste. Imagine. I want to ask you this question, how many of us today committing this sin on daily basis, talking about each other, holding the phone, هل سمعت, هل سمعتي, did you hear, or a woman tell another woman, did you hear, false talk. يا أيها الناس لا تكثروا الكلام بغير ذكر الله. Oh you people, do not increase your talk without remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even in the masjid, coming in the door, taking off your shoes, also take the dunya off your back. And make this moment busy remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كثيرة. وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Keep this tongue moist in the remembrance of Allah everywhere. Anytime you act, keep this tongue moist in the remembrance of Allah. Even Umar radiallahu anhu al-Farooq comes to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq holding his tongue and blaming his tongue for what he spoke bad. Imagine Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said nothing deserves long imprisonment in prison. Lock this tongue out, except this tongue. Take this tongue and lock him up. Keep this tongue busy in the remembrance of Allah. وَشَرُّ النَّاسُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The worst of the people on the day of judgment, ذُو الْوَجْهَيْنِ. ذُو الْوَجْهَيْنِ. Them people with two faces. Long time ago when I was young, when I heard this hadith, I was thinking that people come on day of judgment with two heads, two faces. But it is a tongue is changing, not the face. The tongue is always changing. لا يدخل الجنة نمام. The Nammam, the one who caused corruption, fasad, بين الناس. لا يدخل الجنة. He will not enter Jannah, the one who causes corruptions between two. A master was looking for a servant. He went to the market and he seen this huge man with strength. He was impressed with him. He said, I want to buy him. The owner of this slave, he told him, this man is full of strength, but something is wrong with him. He told him, his lisan, something wrong with his lisan. He talked too much. He told him, I don't care about that. I want to use him in my farm. He will not be close to me. Somehow, this man goes to the master's wife. He's telling her, you know what? Your master doesn't love you anymore. He's remarrying another woman. What you should do is, he told her to grab a piece of hair while he's sleeping and bring me that piece of hair. I'm going to make him fall in love with you again. And he went to his master and told him, your wife doesn't like you no more. She's not in love with you no more. After you get to sleep tonight, she's going to have a knife and she's going to kill you. So this man, while he's asleep, his wife come with a knife. She tried to grab a piece of his hair. She thought he's going to kill him. He took that knife from her and he killed her. Then her people came and killed her. Killed her husband. And then the two people, two families killed each other. Why? Because of kalima. Caused this corruption. Why corruption? Killing. And in our community, our society, wherever you may be, how many times families do not speak to each other because a word, a kalima came out of the tongue. Cause corruption. لابد أن تحضر هذا الثعبان. You have to watch this tongue, what is it speaking? This Imam Masjid, he said, Wallahi, he swears, I was with my mother when she was dying, when his sakaratul maut, when she was in agony of death. Last words, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. And he said, suddenly, beautiful smell start coming out of their room. Beautiful smell. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, when the mu'min as-salih, when the malaika comes to him and pick his soul out, a beautiful smell coming from paradise also with these angels. He said, Wallahi, 2 or 3 days, I can smell that beautiful smell in that room. So people were asking, your mother must was righteous. He said, yes. Besides, she fasted. Besides, she prayed. He said, but my mother always never committed backbiting. لا غيبة ولا نميمة. Whenever we speak about someone, she gets so angry. And she starts making dua for the other party they're talking about.
And this is her jaza. This is her reward. Even Rasulullah said one of the reasons, the punishment of the grave, due to backbiting. And in namima. Is it worth it? Even Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, Ya Rasulullah, إن هذه الامرأة صوامة قوامة ولكن إنها تؤذي جيرانها بلسانها فقال إنها في النار إنها في النار. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he's asking about a woman. She practiced salah, siyam, zakah, hajj, but she harmed her neighbors with her tongue. Harming her neighbors with her tongue. He said, إِنَّهَا فِي النَّارِ. She's in hellfire, she's in hellfire. You see what the lisan is causing you? One kalima, saying, لا إله إلا الله ومحمد رسول الله, makes you enter paradise. Disbelieving in the oneness of Allah make you enter hellfire. Whenever you marry a woman, say, I accept, she becomes halal. When you divorce her, she becomes haram. One word. So, متى تجوز الغيبة? When is غيبة allowed? للتعريف. If I'm talking to you and I don't know the individual's name, I tell him, you know that man, little heavyset person? To describe him, only description, not making fun of him. You know the one who limps a little bit? You know the one, the bull-headed? للتعريف, this is allowed. ثانيا للتظلم, المظلوم يذهب إلى القاضي. The first one, he goes to al-hakim, the judge or the ruler. Atam so-and-so dhalamani, this person dhalamani. And we start talking about him, what happened to him. This is also allowed, this is not ghiba. ثالثاً للاستفتاء. Whenever you go to a alim and you tell him your situation, you tell my son or my wife or my husband or my daughter doing this, what should I do? Seeking for fatwa. This is allowed. ثم في النهي والمنكر. النهي عن المنكر. If you see corruption in this community, you have to warn your brother Muslims about it. And in a case where a man coming to marry your daughter, you go and ask about him. You ask me, I tell him this person so and so, this is not ghiba. Just to give him enough information. A woman came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she told him, oh Rasulullah, two men came to marry me. Who should I choose? He told her, if you choose so and so, he's fakir, maskeen. He's poor and needy. And the other one, he's abusive to women. These allowed in these situations. Other than that, it is ghiba wa namima. فتوبوا إلى الله واستغفروه. استغفر الله وتوب. استغفر الله. يا الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحابته ومن والاه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My last few moments, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to talk to you about Salah. The masjid almost empty during Asr, during Dhuhr, during Maghrib. We have few numbers, Isha and Fajr. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded his Sahaba to come to Baytullah, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this house will come a witness on you on Day of Judgment. They say, oh Allah, I was built and no one came to you. It'll be a witness on you on the Day of Judgment. من غدا إلى المسجد أو راح أعد الله له نزلا كلما غدا أو راح. Whoever comes to the masjid, and we're talking about early in the morning, Salat al-Fajr. الَّذِي يَغْفَلُ عَنْهَا الْكَثِيرُ.
ركعتي الفجر خير من الدنيا وما فيها. Two rak'ah, sunnah, not fard, better than this dunya, silver and gold. وَمَنْ صَلَّى الْفَجْرُ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ كَانَ فِي ذِمَّةِ اللَّهِ أَنْ يَحْفَظَهُ اللَّهُ. Who pray fajr in jama'ah, he will be in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the ulama, they said, if he dies on that day, he should enter Jannah. You are in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to come to the masjid more often, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. So ghiba is a major sin, and namima. So what if some brothers, they said, what if I have committed this ma'asiyah? What should I do? You should mention your brother in another majlis to talk good about him and make istighfar for you and the one you talked about. فالتوبة التوبة يا عباد الله فما أجمل التوبة وما أجمل الرجوع إلى الله فاكتب قصة الرجوع بقلم الندم والدموع واتبعها إلى باب الطاعة وباب الخشوع. إن الله ملائكة صلوا على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gathered all of us here today in his dhikr, in his remembrance, in his obedience, in his worship. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gathered all of us here today in this beautiful day, to gather all of us with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi jannatika. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure all our sins. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure our illness, any from any kind of hardship. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us good in this dunya and bless us good in the hereafter. Allahumma ya Allah, Allahumma inna nas'aluka ya Allah, ya qawi ya aziz, ya samir al-aswat, wa ya mujib al-da'wat, aghfir lana dhunubana. Aghfir lana dhunubana warhamna wahdina warzukna wa yassir lana amrana ya rabbal alameen ya Allah. اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اجمعين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين الموحدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين الموحدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الظالمين. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الظالمين. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الظالمين يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم ارحم موتاهم واشف مرضاهم وعاف مبتلاهم وارحم موتاهم يا قوي يا عزيز لا اله أهلا سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.